Welcome dear students, today we are going to discuss the topic eutectic mixtures. Eutectic system is a binary system consisting of two substances which do not chemically react but miscible in all proportion in liquid phase is called eutectic system. Means simply when they are in the form of liquid, they are miscible with each other, and when they solidify, they separate out from each other. And one more thing is, there is no chemical reaction in between these two components. Now two component system containing solid and liquid phase solid-liquid mixture in which two components are completely miscible in liquid state and completely immiscible as a solids. As we have discussed in definition of your eutectic mixtures, they are miscible in liquid state and they are immiscible or completely immiscible when they get solidified. A eutectic mixture is defined as a mixture of two or more components which usually do not interact to form new chemical compound, but which at certain ratios inhibit crystallization process of one another, and it results into the lowering of the melting point than either of your components. Means when you mix this component with each other, melting point of your individual component get reduced because of the presence of second component. Examples of such a systems are cellol thymol, then cellol camphor, then acetoaminophen and propiphenazone. Now we'll move towards the properties of these eutectic mixtures. What should be the properties? They melts below the melting point of individual component. Means there is a reduction of the melting point because of the presence of another component. Now during formation of the components are miscible in liquid state and completely immiscible in solid state. The melting point is always fixed. Simple eutectic systems. This is the diagram for simple eutectic system. This is showing the temperature. Here component A is 100% and here component B is 100%. As you are moving from left to right, concentration of your component A decreases. Okay, and this is the center point, consists of 50% A, 50% B. And when you are moving from right to left, amount of your B is reduced. Here it is 100%, and when you are moving from right to left, it is decreases up to zero. And same is the case for the component A. Now this A and B are the two components completely miscible in liquid state, and the solution on cooling yield pure A and pure B as a solid phase. This diagram consists of curve A. This curve is known as the freezing point curve of A, and the point A represents the freezing point of your A component, and curve AC shows that freezing point of A falls by addition of your B into the A. Thus doing this curve, the solid A is in equilibrium with liquid solution of B and A. okay, this A is the freezing point of your component A, and as you are increasing your concentration of B, when you are moving from left to right, concentration of A decreases and concentration of B increases. Then melting point of your A is decreases. This line will give you the idea how it is decreases because of the presence of your component B. Now along with this line AC, what happened? There is a presence of solid A equilibrium with the liquid solution of B in A. Then in case of curve B, it is the freezing point curve of B component, and the point B shows freezing point of B, and the curve BC exhibits the fall of freezing point because of the addition of your A into the B. Again, along this line, there is a presence of solid B and liquid A into the, or solution of A into the B exist these two phases along this line BC. And applying the reduced phase rule, equation for the equilibria represented by the curve AC and CB, that is solid A solution and solid B solution represent respectively, we have F is equal to C minus P plus 1. Our phase rule for other system is F is equal to C minus P plus 2. Now here I have taken 1 because it is the condensed phase rule. Condensed phase rule means what? There is absence of vapor phase, means one phase is absent in your system. That's why instead of plus 2, you have to make it correct. Instead of plus 2, you have to put in plus 1. The degree of freedom is 1, that is both mono equilibria are monovariant. Means the point along this line is univariant or monovariant, means which requires only one parameter to define your system completely. Now this is the eutectic point, point of intersection of your AC and CB is known as the eutectic point. The two curves AC and BC intersect with each other at point C. Here both solid AB must be in equilibrium with solution phase. Means along this line, solid B and solution A in base there. Along this line AC, solid A and solution B in A is there, and at this eutectic point, solid A is there, solid B is there, and solution of both of the system or both of the component is there at eutectic point. Now we have condensed phase rule, that is F dash is equal to C minus P plus 1. Now at eutectic point, you have three phase with you. That's why what happened at eutectic point, your value of degrees of freedom will become 0. Thus the system represented by the point C is non-variant, means no a single variable is required to define your system completely. Both temperature and composition of the system, solid A, solid B and solution, are fixed, and the mixture of component A and B as at point C melt at the lowest temperature, that is TE, indicate on the graph. And the point C is therefore called eutectic point. You have to note the temperature, which will give you the eutectic point. It is also known as the TE, that is eutectic temperature, where CE is the composition of corresponding as known are TE temperature. Means what is the composition at eutectic point is known as the CE, that is the concentration or composition of your two component. Eutectic composition and eutectic temperature denoted by CE and TE. The eutectic mixture, although it has a definite melting point, it is not be regarded as a compound. The reasons are, the components are not in a stoichiometric proportion, and on examination under microscope, this reveals the existence of separate crystal of the component. The area above the curve AC and BC, this is the curve AC and BC, and area above this curve here, two components, that is A and B, present as a liquid solution. Means any point from this area above to this AC and CB curve will give you both of your component in the solution form. As a homogeneous solution of A and B constitute one phase only, the system is bivariate, because you require two things to define your system completely. One is composition and one is temperature. Second is temperature. You have one phase with you and two components. That's why your reduced phase will give you the value of degrees of freedom 2. And for that reason, you should know composition, you should know temperature. Then and then only you can locate your point within your area. Therefore, to define the system at any point in this area, both temperature and composition have to be specified. Okay, means you should know these two things, then and then only you can locate the point in between this area. Effect of cooling. When AB solution at any point in the area above to the ACB is cool, then what happened? Cooling dashed line meet the curve AC at point Y. Here what happened? Solid A separate and equilibrium shift down along the curve AC, and the change of the composition and temperature continue till eutectic point of C is reached, when solid B also separates. Thus, in area below to the curve AC and above to the TE, means above to this TE line and below to this AC curve, exist two phases. Which two phases? Solid A and solution of AB, and the system is bivariant. Similarly, cooling of the solution BA on other side of the eutectic point on reaching to the curve BC would yield the B solid B solution system. Thus, the area below to this BC and TE line would represent solid B and solution of AB. If solution just above the eutectic point is cooled and a solid mixture of eutectic composition, that is CE, will obtain straight away. Means when you cool this composition below to this eutectic point, you will get eutectic composition. Now we'll move towards the application of these eutectic mixtures, why it is used. Lidocaine and prilocaine, which are the local anesthetic in nature or in category, used in 1:1 proportion, and this mixture is liquid at a room temperature and form a mixed local anesthetic that may be used for the topical application. Now these are more applications for these eutectic mixture. Eutectic mixture of curcumin and nicotinamide used for the oral route. Is having challenges regarding the oral route and solubility and poor oral bioavailability. Then ibuprofen and thymol. Then ginseng and PEG-460 used by parenteral route. Then Bernol menthol used by nasal route. Then menthol and phloxomer 188 used by rectal route. These are the more applications of your eutectic system. This is all about the eutectic mixtures. Thank you.